It's Jack. It's almost midnight. Almost July 30th, 2022, which means Truro Comic Con is here. I've got two awesome weekends ahead of me. Truro Comic Con this weekend and the weekend after. It's the almighty return of Geek Fest. I'm so excited. Yes. So in the last couple of months, I've been keeping myself busy watching films and enjoying this awesome hella summer of sport, keeping me busy. God bless the BBC and yeah. So everyone's asleep right now and I better get some sleep, so I have to be up very early in the morning, like 8 o'clock, and I should expect to arrive at the gates of Truro College, where Comic Con is always held around 10:30.
Film to watch before sleep, 90 minutes long. Morning! I'm out of the shower and I'm ready to go. Wait, I'm not ready to go just yet. No way I'm going to Comic Con butt naked. Yeah, I'm all dressed now. So, alright, so. Life is strange. Life is strange. Got a new pair of jeans recently and, So, oh, wish I could take my red flannel shirt, but you know, it's summer, it's too hot, so I need a Comic Con to be in autumn so I could, you know, rock those out. Watching a little bit of the marathon before I head off to Truro Comic Con. I could run 26 miles, I guarantee you. Nat! Alright, I got my wallet, my ticket, all dressed, fully awake. Hey ho! Let's go! Truro Comic Con! Woo! Truro Comic Con is getting bigger and bigger. Biggest map yet! Oh, it's a different entrance this year. I'm like, where the heck am I? It's like the opening scene of Spencer, Kristen Stewart playing Princess Diana. She has no idea. She's like, where the fuck am I? But yeah. So yeah, I'm about to get my ticket scanned. All right, wristband on. Yes. I got lost for a few minutes there. I was beginning to panic, but oh, I was trying to find a scanner, but yeah. Wowza. This is a new building, new territory for Truro Comic Con. Here I am in the Sega gaming area. The original Sonic the Hedgehog right over there. Another one.
Hello! So my name is Alex, I'm part of Distinguished Geek on to the Comic Cons. I'm with Jack, so we've been going for how many years now?
I've been to the first Truro Comic Con in 2018.
That's it. Yeah, so we bumped in, so always seem to find out, but obviously with COVID we've been missing each other. But here we go, so
yes.
Starting the game.
Truro Comic Con bigger than ever.
Geek Fest next week?
Yes, of course. Where my cosplay journey started.
Distinguished Geek signing off.
I feel like I've stepped in an alternate universe with this new building. It's hello. Hi, it's so weird. And Bowser. See if we could, you know, go to every building and step on all, like everywhere. Whatever I'm trying to say. But yeah, should be an awesome day out. Oh, wowzer. Holy cowabunga. Bit of Jedi training here. Kieran?
Hello, Jack.
How's it going?
I'm good.
Yeah.
My cosplay day. It's KC from Kick Chameleon, as I said.
Awesome. Wowza, as you teased before at the youth club. Oh, it's new territory here at Truro Comic Con.
Some new amazing stuff I haven't seen as well.
Yeah. Wow. What's this you're checking out here?
I'm just having a look at the fan.
Oh, wow, the fans.
They are nice, aren't they?
They're so cool.
I'm just trying to look for my Team Skull outfit for today as
Booty
well.
Booty hypnotic, make you one ma. It's awesome.
You seen anyone else yet, Jack? Can we know?
Oh, yes, I've seen Guy. Couple of others, you know, recognize me, say hello, they know me as a vlogger here.
We're just separated because I'm trying to have a look around everyone.
So. Uh-huh. Yeah.
I haven't seen anyone from the youth group yet, except you. I'm sure I'll probably come across them sometime.
James will be here later today.
I'm doing the cosplay contest later.
Oh, cool. That's in another building, right?
Yeah, but I don't know where it is, so I'm gonna have to
So far I've bumped into Kieran and a few other friends. Bill and his mother Trish are not here, sadly. But they will be at GeekFest. So Bill and Trish will be in my vlogs at GeekFest. I already feel like I'm having a seizure because I've never been this, obviously this building has never been used at Truro Comic Con before. And it's, but I'm gonna get used to it like usual in previous years. So, I'm gonna go to the main building, the building I'm obviously aware of, so yeah. I've seen a lot of Hatsune Mikus around here. Me want food! Oh, there's the axe throwing over there. I didn't get one in last year, but I'll see if I can do it this year. Whew. Just exploring the whole campus to know the locations and know where I'm going, see where else is, you know, what's on the stores, what's everywhere, and I feel like I'm in a big maze.
Pencil and you have a character sheet.
Seems that like everyone's in good spirits here, and Steampunk Harley Quinn is in jail. What on earth did she do? But this is Alex, by the way, who you remember from my previous vlogs. So, what's happened around the world since the last time I was at Truro Comic Con? Celebrities who have passed away since then. We've said goodbye to Sean Locke, Michael K. Williams, Sarah Harding, Ed Asner, Meatloaf, Betty White, Sydney Poitier, so many we've lost in the last 12 months. But what's also happened in the last 12 months? We heard the slap that was heard around the world. Yes, Will Smith slapped Chris Rock at the Oscars. Everybody saw. I think everybody saw. That was the most talked about event of last year. Will Smith slapping Chris Rock at the Oscars. But I was lucky to see King Richard before that slap, and it was a great film. Will Smith deserved his Oscar. What also happened around the world? Russia invaded Ukraine. Vladimir Putin cost UK the Eurovision victory. Sorry. Anyway. Without the war, the UK would have won Eurovision. Or maybe Spain, Sweden, I don't know. But also, Ben Affleck is canon again, and now Ben Affleck and Jennifer Lopez are married! Woo-hoo-hoo! I've seen a few cosplayers that have caught my eye so far. Jinx from Arcane. Arcane was the best series I watched last year. That was a phenomenal series. Maybe the best animated series I ever watched. I have to say hi to her later. Maybe there's another Jinx around. See if anybody reacts. Sweet Caroline! No, didn't work. Oh well. Look what we have here, the gamers bus. Wowza. Not sure what footballer's doing on a gamer's pass, but...
Hi guys, how's it going? I'm here with the Farm of TARDIS at the convention here in Truro, having a great time. Very busy.
Stepping in the TARDIS for the first time in 3 years. Last time I was in the TARDIS, it was before the C word took over. Oh, yeah. If I step out of here, I have to make sure if I'm in my universe, there's no, you know, surreal or striking differences. They say if you go back in time, if you move a chair, things will change drastically when you come back. Since the last Truro Comic Con, the best TV series I have watched, Arcane, obviously, based on the League of Legends games. I never played the League of Legends, but the series was fantastic. Also, I was gonna say, Arcane was amazing. I thought Maid was brilliant. Margaret Qualley, an amazing lead performance, a very emotional roller coaster series. And Cruel Summer was so overlooked. That was so good, based in the 90s. And the last minute, I'm like, oh, you didn't. Yeah. Recently, I'm watching Halo, great series, and The First Lady, based on various American First Ladies. Viola Davis as Michelle Obama is perfect casting. So, hello! Here she is, Jinx from Arcane. Oh my god, such an amazing series. I cannot wait for season 2. Oh, it was amazing. And you admitted you followed me.
Oh, I'm just mum.
Yeah, so how long did it take to decorate your Jinx cosplay?
Handmade thing here.
Oh, okay.
Loads of weeks to do. It's just made out of clay.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's
rock solid. So. Mm-hmm. Cool. Yeah, I mean, Arcane was phenomenal. I was just talking about, it was among the best series I watched last year, along with Maid, Cruel Summer. But, oh, wow, Arcane was, every episode was a masterpiece. The soundtrack was excellent.
Soundtrack, yeah.
Excellent. Ella Purnell did a brilliant job voicing Jinx. And it was her first voiceover role.
Seriously?
Yeah, it was amazing. Another series I really liked was Yellow Jackets.
I would watch that.
Oh, that is so good. Oh, it's messed up, but it is so good. It is.
Oh yeah, they're still with me.
Here they are. Yeah. But.
Have a good time, Jack.
Thank you very much. I've seen a lot of folks around here wearing Hellfire Club t-shirts. Now, 3 months ago, I was in a flash forward to see what was going around Truro Comic Con. People wearing Hellfire Club t-shirts. I'm like, is this a new Fight Club? Hello, guy.
Hello, Jack. How are you?
How's it going?
Hi.
Having a great time?
Yes.
Yeah, have a very good
Stocked
time.
Stocked up on anime teachers.
Wicked, yeah. Awesome.
Yeah, all dressed well.
It's always good to see you too.
You personally.
Yeah. So, is Hellfire Club the new Fight Club? Oops, I already broke the first two rules. Never mind. Like Jeremy Clarkson would say, oh no. Anyway, Deadpool! What's that? You have no idea. When's Deadpool 3 coming out? Have a good time. One thing I forgot to mention is that, you know, I was saying earlier about Eurovision, the UK is hosting Eurovision next year. Yes! Wowza, it's actually happening. The UK is hosting Eurovision, but which host city? Glasgow, Manchester, Birmingham, Cardiff, Bristol, Edinburgh? I don't know, but oh my god, I need to go to Eurovision next year. It's so unbelievable. Like this time last year, if I had told anyone, do you think UK would finish in top 5 the year after and host Eurovision year after? Everybody would have laughed at me. But UK did finish second this year, and of course Ukraine won due to sympathy votes. Ukraine unable to host the contest, so the UK is hosting on behalf of Ukraine. It's bittersweet. Who's going to be the presenters of Eurovision? Oh, got to get Graham Norton in there somewhere. He is the heart and soul for UK's party for Eurovision. Rylan, Dermot O'Leary, Alison Hammond would be a right laugh. So many endless possibilities of who could present Eurovision next year. If they do get a Ukrainian presenter, it would be awesome if they got Mila Jovovich to present as one of the presenters. Because, of course, she was born in Ukraine and, you know, on behalf of Ukraine. Yeah, you get the idea. Just bumped into another Jinx cosplayer. Oh. Yeah, and it's drizzling as feared at Truro Comic Con FFS. So, as I was saying earlier, is Hellfire Club the new Fight Club? Just saw someone with a Hellfire Club t-shirt and I said, is that the new Fight Club? And she said, you don't talk about that. Ah ha ha, somebody is cultured. Face in the youngsters restored, but under 18s allowed to watch Fight Club. All right, a young kid in a Hellfire Club shirt just came up to me and said, I want to join Fight Club. What have I done? I did tell him to don't talk about Fight Club. So I was just playing Sonic the Hedgehog in the Sega gaming zone. And yeah, it was actually on the actual Mega Drive. It was the first time I actually played Sonic with a Mega Drive controller, because I've always played the original Sonic the Hedgehog game, 1991, either the GameCube controller, Xbox controller, or online. That was the first time I was playing Sonic the Hedgehog in 1991 with the original Mega Drive controller, so it was a bit of a culture shock to me. So, let's go jaywalking. Wait, is this called jaywalking? I don't know. I have no freaking idea. Oh, here I am back on the Stranger Things couch. Speaking of Stranger Things, life is strange. Stranger Things. Yeah, last time I sat on this couch was 3 years ago, before our whole world turned upside down, no pun intended. Now, recently, I did watch the first season of Stranger Things for the first time. My verdict? Good show, but I'm not that invested like most other people. I think there's better series. Hopefully no one heard that, they're gonna smack me. But I think Stranger Things is a good series. First season, Winona Ryder, David Harbour, one of my favourite performances. Lucas is my favourite of the kids. Can't remember the name of the actor who plays him, but I think it'd be a great choice to play Pele in a biopic. Not sure if I want to watch the second or third season or fourth season of Stranger Things. It's just, I don't know. I know people went mental over the fourth season, saying it was the best season yet. Maybe because of two scenes. Come on, let's be realistic. But yeah, I'm waiting for season 5 of The Crown.
I'm an escape from Demon Slayer. That's about all you're gonna get.
By the way, this girl was in Traptor last year, yeah. And she's awesome with her cosplays. You at Geekfest next week?
Yes.
Hella yes. I cannot wait. There's a lot of Hellfire Club t-shirts here.
Yeah.
I've been saying, is it the new Fight Club? And there's a little kid like, I want to join Fight Club. I'm like, no, you're not meant to talk about Fight Club. Because I was joking, Fight Club was a Hellfire Club back when I was a kid. We're all having a good time here at Truro Comic Con. Just bumped into a fan of mine. Not really a fan of mine, but as an avid viewer of all my vlogs. He was so excited to see me. Yo! You know, it's just... did a big, you know, high five, just awesome. And he told me a very, very dirty joke I dare not say in my vlogs or even tweet, or I'll be cancelled by... I miss the days when there was no cancel culture. Hellfire Club t-shirts seem to be getting more passed around than Jada Pinkett Smith. So I'm having a quick snack break. Mm. a lot of people here are also enjoying their little snack breaks, sitting on the grass, because all seats and tables are full, but it's better to sit on the grass. TBF. Looks like Caitlin's gone for a cuppa. Yes, Caitlin from Arcane. I've been ridiculous. Does anyone here know Sweet Caroline, the song? Bum bum bum. Nobody's done that. Every time I sing Sweet Caroline, just honestly. I finally found both James, and one of them has turned into Tommy Vercetti from Grand Theft Auto.
Remember that name.
I will. That's a excellent cosplay. You had it in mind for months, didn't you?
Yeah, I have.
And it was unfortunately Ray Liotta passed away recently.
My tribute to him.
Definitely. A great actor. And I watched a film with him recently. Copland. Sylvester Stallone.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
That's on Paramount Plus.
Oh, right.
Yeah. But it's a great film, yeah. So, how was your year at Plymouth University?
It was pretty damn good, actually.
Yeah. When's your graduation ceremony?
Yeah, that's going to be in September, actually, which I believe
cool.
is the forecast day after I'm on stage. Hopefully.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know what the hell the Fire Club is?
The Hellfire Club?
Yeah.
I think that's the thing from this. It's Marvel. Yeah.
I know. Everybody's wearing this Fire Club thing.
Yeah,
it's just...
I've been joking around,
you know, is it the new Fight Club? Now there's kids going around telling their parents, I want to join Fight Club. Oh dear, they're too young to watch a film anyway.
I was thinking of the Hellfire Club from the X-Men franchise, I suppose.
Fire! Basil Fawlty.
I love that.
Our greatest TV episode in history.
Where's the key? Where is it?
Thank you, God! Thank you so bloody much!
That's my favourite episode.
That, as I said, greatest TV episode ever.
Yeah, definitely. Even if it is, well, obviously, like, old TV series is politically incorrect now.
Oh, God. I've been saying earlier, I miss when council culture didn't exist and people were too... I miss when people weren't too sensitive and cancelling older TV shows and films. Just, But, I mean, Vice City, the soundtrack still kicks ass.
Definitely. Especially because they have the V-Rock station, which has a lot of metal songs in there.
Mm-hmm.
Iron Maiden, Judas Priest, Twisted Sister, and...
Now, I like all radio stations, but I love the song Self Control by Laura Branigan. I live among the creatures of night.
One of my other favourite ones is the song I Ran by A Flock of Seagulls, which which they played on the trailer for Grand Theft Auto.
I like Mr. Mister, Broken Wings.
That's a good song, yeah.
One of my favourite 80s tunes.
And obviously Africa by Toto.
Of course, who can forget Toto and Africa? I was talking to James because he's cosplaying Tommy from Grand Theft Auto Vice City. It's just struck me that GTA Vice City is turning 20 years old this year. Damn, I feel old. Other games turning 20 this year, Star Fox Adventures, Super Mario Sunshine, Eternal Darkness. I was going to say Luigi's Mansion, but that was actually originally came out in 2001, but it came out in Europe 2002, like the GameCube and Xbox consoles. But yeah, what films came out 20 years ago? Lord of the Rings, Two Towers, the first Spider-Man film, the Tobey Maguire, came out 20 years old. I feel old. Other films that are turning 20, The Pianist, harrowing film, but brilliant film. The musical Chicago is turning 20 this year. Insomnia, Al Pacino and Robin Williams, very underrated film. And of course, every film Christopher Nolan directs is amazing. But there's so many films trying to think of 2002. Oh, my brain is already getting overloaded. But yeah. Also 20 years ago, the greatest ever Big Brother series aired, which was the one with Alex Sibley, Kate Lawler, Alison Hammond, and the late Jade Goody.
Hello, my name is Don, and I'm a Lego artist. I do a lot of commissions, and at the moment we are showing off here in Truro We've got a big Darth Vader that was made for a special Star Wars charity event where actors were going to basically appear and be photographed with him. So it needed to be the same size as the actor who played Darth Vader, Dave Prowse. And it needed to be three-dimensional. And we found a way of making it three-dimensional by putting it at an angle.
Hello, little friend.
Spike.
Spike. That's a nice name. Aww. How are you? Having a good time at Truro Comic Con? Awesome. Me too. Do you feel a little hot? Oh yeah, it's been very hot around Cornwall the past couple of weeks.
He likes it hot.
I like it hot too. I mean, it's the summer.
Better than cold.
Because you're hot and you're cold and oh! Oh!
Spike, no. No biting.
Nom 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 nom. Love lifts us up where we belong. One thing that hasn't changed at Comic Con is the amount of Hatsune Miku's I see flocking around. I mean, she's like the figurehead of the anime community, and Hatsune Miku is awesome. So yeah, it's always great seeing a lot of Hatsune Miku's around here. And, right, yeah, so, wow, so many diverse cosplayers around here spanning various forms of media. That's how I like it at Comic Con. That's the way, I like it, How are you, sir? Awesome, now gonna enter the gamer's bus. I see Minecraft. I see Mario Kart. I see football. Oh, I can't wait for the Women's Euros final tomorrow. Come on, England. Excuse my enthusiasm, folks. We all need a fan right now. Oh my god, in front of me, I believe, is General Grievous. Is it? Unless... Wow. Oh wait, it's not. But I mean...
How tall is he? Wow!
That is spectacular!
That is incredible. Oh no, oh no, thank you!
Are you General Grievous?
Of course.
Huh?
Of course.
Oh yes, I was worried it was going to misidentify you, but yeah, I recognise you. Revenge of the Sith is still my favourite Star Wars film. Definitely. But wow, that is impeccable. Around the world, 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 around the world. This song is 25 years old.
Really?
Yeah, it's 25 years old. I'm 29.
Oh.
I'm 6 months away from hitting 30. I'm scared.
The song is younger than you.
Films that are turning 25 this year, that came out 25 years ago. Titanic, Men in Black. Mm-hmm. Titanic came out 25 years ago. So did Men in Black, LA Confidential, The Full Monty. Long time no see, Alex. How's it going?
About 2 years now.
2 years. Is it 3 years? 4 years. Last time we saw each other, the C word didn't exist.
Yeah.
Yeah, so much has changed in our world since. Oh. My god, and I've pretty much changed a lot as a person. Oh.
Sounds alright.
Yeah. I'm just... Although I've kind of changed myself as a person, but I still love the same things. I watch a movie every night.
Oh, good.
You know, I just, you know, troll celebrities online and just... Well, how do you like Caitlin? Have you seen Arcane?
No.
Shame on you. There's still plenty of time until the second season comes out. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes, that's right. It's on
League of Legends. Yeah. Mm.
I might have wanted to, but I don't know. I played League of Legends for a bit. So my play is one of the big throwing presents.
Yeah.
But like,
oh, there's a lot of them at this point.
I'm back to World of Warcraft.
Yeah, the best series I watched in the last 12 months are Arcane, Maid, Cruel Summer, The Gilded Age. That's from the creator of Downton Abbey, his new show. That's really good. I know there are mixed reviews for the new Halo series, but I thought it's excellent. One more episode left to be released on Paramount Plus in the UK. But there's a few, there's two episodes that did leave me bored, but the action scenes, the acting and the production cinematography is fantastic. Although the main story is very different from the main Halo canon, and you know, but yeah, it's really good for what it is. Mm-hmm. I haven't watched the new Resident Evil yet, but I've heard it's meant to be utter shite.
I've heard that.
Mm. I think the. Yeah.
Because TV to be so bad lately, I watched Game of Thrones again.
Oh, really? That was quite fun. Oh, despite the awful last season, everybody flipped out over.
Yeah, exactly.
That seems to be a trend now. Bad last seasons, two brilliant shows everybody raves about. It happened with Ozark, Line of Duty, happened with Killing Eve, maybe soon Stranger Things.
And Humans, actually. That was a good series.
Oh, I've been watching Humans. The first two seasons were brilliant. Yeah. Haven't got to the third season yet, but you say it's disappointing.
It's
well, you know, I watched, you know, Buffy the Vampire Slayer. The last two seasons were bad. That's way going way back. I mean, the first five seasons are really good. The last two seasons I ignore. Should have ended at season five, where Buffy sacrifices herself for everyone. Would have been the perfect ending. Yeah. I'm looking forward to when the live action Life is Strange series is out. Ever play that game?
I'm aware of it.
Oh my god, because I got the shirt, Life is Strange. But it's an amazing game. It's a spectacular story. And every few months, I come up with my dream cast of the characters. They change every few months. And and also been watching a lot of series and films. I watch a lot of older films as well, and series in recent years that I can get around to. Have you heard of Sharp Objects? That is a really good but messed up series. A shocking twist at the end. Oh, brilliant. Almost. Oh my god, that's two. Zodiac is David Fincher's best film, in my opinion. Closely followed by Gone Girl. Gone Girl was fantastic, and it made me scared. I'm never getting married. No. That's an amazing film.
Oh gosh, well, I didn't want to watch that then.
The Social Network is really good. That defined a
Social Network is great. Andrew Garfield.
Now, I find things like that a bit scary.
Mm. Andrew Garfield should have got an Oscar for that film. He was brilliant. Have you seen Tick, Tick, Boom?
I saw the start of it.
Oh, that is a brilliant film. He was incredible. I'm not really into musicals, but I love that film.
Respect to Andrew Garfield so much. Mm. I watched every movie he's in because I
Oh, he's brilliant. Have you seen Never Let Me Go? That is brilliant. Yeah, Andrew Garfield's in that. That's a brilliant film, yeah.
I'm going to see that.
It's very emotional, based on a book.
He's my favourite Spider-Man.
Oh, cool.
And mm-hmm. I love the Social Network.
Oh, yeah.
I watched Tick, Tick, Boom, but I don't really like musicals, but Andrew Garfield's great.
Say, I'm not a big fan of musicals, but Tick, Tick, Boom was amazing.
And Hacksaw Ridge is one of my favorite movies.
Oh, I haven't seen that yet, but I've heard it's really good. But,
So inspirational.
About Jake Gyllenhaal, have you seen Nightcrawler?
Oh, yeah.
That is a brilliant film. Oh, how did he not get an Oscar nomination for that? I have no idea. Show me the money! Show me the money! Oh, you had me at hello. You had me at hello.
You complete me.
You know your films.
Yeah.
Do you mind if I film you?
I'm fine.
Yeah, I upload to my vlogs on YouTube about Jake Gyllenhaal. Oh, he's one of my favourite actors. You've seen Prisoners. That is a brilliant film. Amazing. A rough film to watch. And that...
Intense.
That car scene where Jake Gyllenhaal was driving the girl to the hospital. I'm like, don't crash, don't crash, don't crash. Oh my God, I was so panicking. And then at the end, we hear the whistle. I'm like, don't leave, don't leave. And it ends like that. I'm like, no!
And what's the actor that plays Paul Dano?
Paul Dano, yeah.
In fact, you kind of really think it's him.
Oh, you do think it's him, but
he acts so well. He acts crazy.
Mm. It's ironic. His name is Alex Jones, twinned with a conspiracy theorist on. He was banned on YouTube, but Paul Dano. I've not seen the new Batman film yet, but I've heard he's brilliant as the Riddler. There's a clip in Prisoners where Hugh Jackman, he says to Paul Dano, locking himself, you know, no more fucking riddles. A bit of a foreshadowing there. Yeah. And Paul Dano also directed a film starring Jake Gyllenhaal called, Wildlife. Yeah. Set in the 60s. That's a that's a really good film.
Paul Dano's great.
Oh, brilliant.
I love the scene where he just says no repeatedly. He's just like a child in that scene.
There's a Paul Dano film I watched lately, Love and Mercy. It's a biopic on the Beach Boys. Yeah. That's really good because he plays Brian Wilson.
You've seen The Girl Next Door with Paul Dano?
Yes, yeah. I watched that last year for the first time.
It's a good movie.
Yeah. Alicia Cuthbert. Woo. And recently I watched The Father with Anthony Hopkins. Heartbreaking film.
No, I haven't seen that one.
That's a really good, it's on Netflix. And... there's one film I've not seen, but I mean to get to for years. Brothers.
Oh my God, Jake Gyllenhaal, Tobey Maguire.
And Natalie Portman.
That is one of the best movies.
Oh, have you seen it?
I have seen it, yeah.
Oh, because I know that scene where, you know, it's like Tobey Maguire has a big freak out in the kitchen. Yeah. Oh, just... I wish he was in more films.
Yeah, the fact that they don't cast him anymore, apart from No Way Home. Because he was Spider-Man. They had to do that. But, yeah, the fact that they didn't cast him in anything, like, separate. it's so wrong. He's a great actor. When he was, that scene where he's got to beat up that guy. It's so heart-pounding.
Ever seen Unbroken?
Unbroken? No, I haven't.
It's based on a true story. This, you know, American Olympic athlete. You know, he serves in a war and he's taken prisoner of war in Japan. Oh, that is a brilliant film. Angelina Jolie directed it. It's awesome talking to you, Spider-Man, and your impressive knowledge of films. Here we are, we have Rouge and her friend.
Spider-Man,
awesome, unmasked. That's cool.
The best kind of crossover film.
Because I saw you, I'm like, that heart. I'm like, oh, are you Rouge? I'm like, yes. I hope Rouge will be in Sonic 3.
I hope so too.
Yeah, have you seen Sonic 2?
Yes.
I liked it more than the first one. It was a lot funnier.
I know that Shadow's going to be in it.
Yes, I anticipated after I saw the first one 2 years ago, I thought that Shadow has got to be in the middle of the credits of the second movie.
Yeah.
And oh my God, I couldn't contain my excitement. Who's going to voice Shadow?
I don't know.
A lot of people want Keanu Reeves. I think Daniel Craig would be a good Shadow. Yeah. Also, other good choices to voice Shadow. John Bernthal, he would be really good. Denzel Washington is wishful thinking. If Rouge is in Sonic 3, who'd you like to hear voice Rouge?
Oh, I don't know. Me.
Oh, that would be cool. Yeah, you nominate yourself. That's really cool.
Best choice.
I think Jennifer Hudson would be awesome. The singer and actress. You've heard of her? Yeah, because she recently played Aretha Franklin in a biopic, which was fantastic. And I think Jennifer Hudson would be awesome. Or maybe Viola Davis. She'd be amazing voicing Rouge. That's wishful thinking. Who'd voice Amy? Renee Zellweger?
Me again.
Oh, what's her name? All right, her name, Anna Kendrick. She'd make a really good Amy Rose. Yeah, by the way, I have a big knowledge of films, actors, directors. So they come to my mind all the time.
Sonic isn't my expertise, I would say.
Sonic is your expert subject.
It's not my expert
subject. Oh, it's not your, yeah, obviously no. It's Spider-Man. Yeah. Who's your favourite Spider-Man?
Gas.
Tom Holland.
I have to say, I love Andrew as well.
Andrew Garfield. He's developed such into a really good actor.
Yeah.
He was fantastic in Tick, Tick, Boom.
Yeah, we watched that last night.
Last night?
Yeah.
Speak of the devil.
Yeah, it was crazy.
It's a brilliant... I remember watching the film at Christmas. I thought, oh my God, Andrew Garfield's going to win the Oscar. Then a month later, I saw King Richard with Will Smith, where he plays the father, the Williams sisters. I'm like, okay, it's between Andrew Garfield and Will Smith. I'm happy with either way. When I woke up in the news who won the Oscars, I'm like, what did Chris Rock do? What did he do?
Yeah.
And I'm like... Oh my God, I thought La La Land blooper could not be surpassed. Keep my wife's name out your... Nah, I'm not going to do it. But yeah. Actually, maybe Andrew Garfield can voice Shadow.
Yeah. Mm. That would be a best crossover
ever. I think Andrew Garfield's career was always going to take off for his great performance in The Social Network. Have you seen The Social Network? That's a brilliant film. And Never Let Me Go, that's a proper tearjerker. It's on your watch list.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. I must warn, it's a proper tearjerker. I even cried at the end.
Yeah, he's such a good actor.
Oh, brilliant actor. This is a kawaii photo shoot set. This is really wonderfully set up. Gorgeous trees. Ah. Let's have a walk around.